What is good, guys? We are back with game 2 between Sabella and Googly. Let's look at the teams real quick. Googly's back with some wild stall team, this time with a Muk, a Roxtota, Rox Lando. And yeah, looking at Sabella's team, that's a defensive Lando. Most likely he's quite weak to Zygarde. Either Rox Lando or Rox Tren. If it's defensive Lando, it's most likely Rox Tren, because Rox Tren has like a higher chance to get a Rox versus a Sableye, and he knows that Googly likes stall, so he has to prepare for Sableye. Googly leads up with a Ditto to scout Sabella's lead. He basically already got information. He knows the entire moveset from Landorus now. I assume that's Ashgren with Specs and Spikes, a Scarf Lady is gonna get tripped by Muk in this game, and like Sabella's probably gonna try to keep doubling out on a Muk later. Mawile plus Seatron look like threats to Googly, and Rotom looks a bit annoying because he can spam Will Wisp. And if he gets rid of Seismitoad, Rotom can spam Volt Switch, and it's gonna be super annoying for Googly. So he feels Protect. I assume this is a Protect U-turn of Quick HP Ice, Landorus, and Rocks on Heatran. I already mentioned that Heatran gets up Rocks better with Sableye, so that makes a lot of sense to me. So yeah, Sabella can just U-turn out here, even if this is Helmet Albemarle. I don't think that's the end of the world for him, because he has lefties on this and he has Protect to get health back. He goes back into Ditto, not 100% sure what he predicted there. But yeah, Sabella can go in with Rotom here and fire off a Will-O-Wisp. He has no Will-O-Wisp immunity. Other option would be going into Greninja and getting up a Spike. I assume that the Defog Scissor, obviously, to get rid of hazards. Interesting that this team doesn't have Heal Bell. So Will-O-Wisp is gonna be super annoying for the Googly's team here. Usually you see like Rest on Seismitoad with like Heal Bell support, but since he doesn't have Heal Bell, let's see if he has some other, like, I think, yeah, exactly, Seismitoad gets refreshed to get rid of status, that's what I was thinking. So the Muk is really obvious here, so I can see him doubling out into like Mawile. Oh, okay, Heatran. I thought Mawile would have been fine there, but yeah, this works as well. Because, yeah, depending on if the Mawile has Intimidate or Hypercutter, it can potentially get walled by Lando, and Albemarle can also, like, check it pretty well. He gets up his rocks there to pressure him, that's really nice. I assume Googly's gonna get up either his own rocks, or he can go for like maybe a knockoff predicting a switch into Rotom or Lari to get rid of an item. He can also just go for Scald and fish for Burn. He has a few options here. But yeah, if Sabella can get up, keep up rocks and get up a Spike with Greninja, and that's some really nice offensive pressure on Googly. So he gets a Scald on a Lari there. The Muk is really obvious here. Let's see if he doubles out again. Now if he just attacks this time. Okay, this time he doesn't double out. What does he go for? He goes for Trick, so he tricks away Scarf. So the Muk loses the Assault Vest, which means that Magma Storm slash Earth Power from Heatran will do a lot more damage to the Muk. The Pursuit is pretty obvious here, yeah. I thought he would have gone for Draco to weaken this a bit. But just in case he went for a knockoff there, he tried to switch into Mawile, I assume. So Mawile has Hypercutter. We see it doesn't have Intimidate. That means Lando cannot switch in that well, because Mawile wouldn't get Intimidated pre-Mega Evolution. So I assume he's gonna go into either Scissor or Albemarle here. Depending on the Albemarle set, if it's like more Fist David, can easily switch into Mawile, and then he can pivot into Lando from there to get off the Intimidate, because now the Mawile Mega, as we see, is a Rocky Helmet Albemarle. The player have still did a good chunk. Looking at Sabella's team, actually I think this is not Fire Fang, because he has a Heatran and a Rotom to deal with Scissor. And Ferrothorn is a bit annoying, but it's not the end of the world for his team, so I don't think he has Fire Fang. I think he's like, so he pivots into Lando, he takes a good chunk. But yeah, talking about the Mawile, it's probably SD3 attacks, Sucker Punch, Player Off, and then either Thunder Punch or Knockoff. So he finally gets up his own rocks, so rocks are on both sides now. Sabella can go for a U-turn here, because Googly's probably gonna fear the HP Ice. And yeah, this is not the end of the world, like I said, the helmet damage is not that bad for him. And chip on Albemarle is nice, and if he gets up spikes on top of the rocks, it's gonna be even better for him. If I recall correctly, the Seismitoad isn't burned anymore, so he's gonna Wisp again here and burn it, yeah. Because he released Refresh, right? Mm-hmm. So Googly can go for a knockoff here, or I guess Scald would work as well, because you don't want to give Mawile free switches. But he's not gonna go hard Mawile. Mawile is a big threat. He goes in a Greninja. So I guess he's gonna bluff that he has something to hit the Seismitoad, or if the Seismitoad is more Fizz Dev, Googly's gonna switch. What does Googly even have to switch into this? I guess he can go to Muk, but Muk also already lost the Assault Vest, and it's gonna get chipped from rocks. Sabella has Spikes, he can go for that here, that would be a nice play for sure, to put more pressure on Googly. He has Spikes and Rocks up now, amazing, so it's Ashgren. Yeah, I assume it's just Specs. He gets Pursuited here, some nice chip. Does he get the Poison? He does not get the Poison. He goes in a Heatran here, so he didn't go more while potentially freeing Muk having Fire Blast. So I don't think the Muk has revealed this entire moveset yet. I think it already only revealed Pursued. But yeah, he can go for Magma Storm here because going hard into Ditto is a bit too risky for Googly on the potential off power. And Googly doesn't have good switches to this because Seismitoad will have to take Hazards, and I think it's burned, right? It has to take Hazards and Magma Storm recall aftermath thing if Magma Storm hits. So I would definitely go for Magma Storm here since you have a Hazards. I don't think you have to predict that Ditto that can potentially come out. And yeah, it's definitely looking nice for Sabella. He has to win this to force a game 3. And he definitely has the tools to win with like Rotom spamming Will-O-Wisp. We don't know. I think the Rotom is Aya Papa Berry. It didn't show lefties if I recall correctly. So he Magma Storms here. If Googly doesn't go for Earthquake here and Sabella stays in, this could potentially be really deadly for Googly. I think he has to like at least go for Scald to do good damage to the Heatran. He does get a speed death drop, so Sabella with a really risky play sting, and then it paid off. This is like a game-changing turn. Like, I mean, he's able to win this. Sabella has the... Why can I not talk? Sabella has the tools to win this game anyway, but this puts him in a really good position. This risky play, I probably wouldn't have made that play, good god. So he scares this out with the Earth Power, and I think Googly's gonna go for Magma Storm, or some sort of... depending on the last move, it could be Toxic or Taunt. I thought he would have gone for that. He doubles out. I think he anticipated the lander to come out. And doubled into Scissor to defog, but it didn't work out at all for him. Because now Sabella can just Will-O-Wisp and the Scissor took Hazards. And now the Seismitoad is dead. He can Will-O-Wisp spam and Volt Switch spam around with the Rotom. As he like wishes. And why did he stay in to roost? If anything, you defog there, I think, right? To be fair, this is tough for Googly at this point. I don't see him winning this at all. And I don't know why he bullet punched there at all. There's a Volt Switch, his Scissor's getting willed. Does he not have defog on this? Like, he is a stall team, it should have defog. But yeah, Sabella can go for Magma Storm here. Like I said, Hazards are up, so the Ditto would get punished even if it comes in on Magma Storm and absorbs it with the Flash Fire. He hits and the Lando is dead. And it's looking really nice for Sab. So he's gonna go Ditto here, that's like the only thing he has to force the Heatran out because Alamomola is piss weak and Scald from Alamomola doesn't do enough to Heatran. So he's gonna threaten us out with the off power and he's gonna go for Magma Storm or double out again. But he can Sabella can just go Rotom here. Like I said, we don't know the last move if it's Toxic or Taunt. If it's Toxic he can go for that as well. He goes for Toxic, okay, he catches the Rotom. Sabella can Volt Switch here. He knows the Ditto is locked in the Toxic, the Heatran. And whatever comes in will have to take Hazards. Muk is gonna take a lot of damage here. It's gonna do like 15 maybe? 16, okay. Because the AV got knocked off. And Rotom's Aya Papa Berry is gonna activate in a few turns as well after with Rocks and Poison. And I think he can just go for Earthquake here. Like I said, even if Googly goes in the Ditto, he still has to take Hazards, and Googly might go into like Alamomola here because he might anticipate HBIs. I feel like Earthquake is pretty free here. Yes, he can go for HBIs, but I feel like Earthquake is just super free for him. And this Muk is just death fodder if he switches out. But yeah, Scissor's already burned, Hazards are up. Muk is pretty much dead. And Mola has Helmet that doesn't even have lefties, and I don't think Mola is going to be able to keep the entire team healthy. He goes in a Mola, as okay, Sabella tries to predict him to go in a Ditto, and goes for Impower Ice. Goes for U-turn there, and Alamola is going to wish here. I feel like the Rotom is going to come out here to Volt Switch or Will-O-Wisp again. Rocks plus Toxic, almost bring him in the berry range. Like, he should be berry range. The Rotom set is pretty common. Like, Rotom overall is not common in Sun Moon OU, but when you if you see a Rotom, most of the time it has the Aya Papa Berry set. Especially in tournament play, I think Benge used it and Blunder used the Benge team in a tour, and it was always the set. Yeah, that's the set with the berry. And yeah, he can just... okay, Volt Switch. I thought Will-O-Wisp was fine as well, but yeah, Volt Switch works. Aloe's forced to go for Wish again, but yeah, Aloe's not gonna be able to, like I said, to keep his entire team healthy. It also has to keep itself healthy, like, he just can't handle that. He has to protect here. I don't think he can switch in. I mean, he can switch into... If Dedo can tank hazards, I think Dedo has one more switch in, right? I don't remember how healthy it is. If Dedo has one more switch in, he can potentially go to that, but his ally would be super low if he doesn't protect here. So he's, yeah, he was kind of forced to go for that. Yeah, Earthpaw was a fine play there. I think Ella was in range from Earthpaw, maybe it was a roll, but Earthpaw also covers the Ditto and also kills the Mug. So, Sabala can go for Toxic here. Ghouli might just sack off his Mug here. And then he has to go into, after he sacks the Mug, he has to go into Ditto to force this out, but like, this game is heavily in Sabala's favor, like, we're gonna get a game 3 most likely, So yeah, this is gonna die the Earthpaw super free here. He goes get back into Albemola, but the hazards plus Earthpaw damage does more than regenerator healed, so like even if he goes back to sack the Mug now to get regen with Aloe, I don't know about that play. Like, to be fair, this game is pretty over. So like, I'm not gonna say Googly misplayed at this point. We've talked about this, a crucial turn was Trent staying in on the Seismitoad, and yeah, I definitely, I don't know if I wouldn't have made that play, that was a wild play, good god. But yeah, now he sacks the Mug to get some regen, and he can go into Ditto here, threaten this with the Earthpaw, and fire off a Magma Storm expecting a switch or something, but like, this game is just over. Greninja kinda wins the game, Morwall also put some pressure. What else? Scizor's burned, so like, even if Morwall doesn't have Fire Fang, like, Scizor is not a counter. That wasn't the Scizor expecting. What? So is he's gonna try to roost up here. That didn't work out for Googly. He can just Voltage here. He finally gets a defog off, but yeah, I know the Scizor's basically dead. It's gonna die to burn here. Sabala can go to his Heat Train here, or to Lando to get some lefties. He goes to Lando to get some lefties. After this turn? Not this, yeah, at this point. He has to go Albemola here and Wish. And the rocks can go back up here. Or he can just U-turn out. Yeah. And he turned out into Gren, or into Rotom, okay. he can Will-O-Wisp here, or Paint Split if he has it. You know, Volt Switch and Will-O-Wisp. I think that's about all he has shown yet, and Hydro Pump is obvious. The last move could be Toxic or Pain Split. I've used a Toxic rune when I had Aya Papa, but Pain Split is fire in this matchup and he actually has it, that's nice. To annoy Googly even more, but it's not like Googly can win this anyway. Switches out on a potential Protect because he doesn't want to take more poison on a Rotom. Googly might go on a Heat Turn here, predicting a Toxic to come out. Yeah, he does do that, and if he breaks that and goes for Earthpaw, the game ends right here, but he doesn't predict it. So now he has to switch again. But it doesn't really matter what he does, because he has more sex and everything, like... Yeah, Googly tried to catch him on a stay-in, but he's not gonna stay in. Volt Switch is knowing that Heatran was locked, the Ditto was locked in the Earthpaw, free Volt Switch, and yeah, Morwall. Can click Play Rough here, and I think the Alo dies. Yeah, I think it did like 52 earlier. He does connect, and the game is over. Because the Ditto has to lock itself into a move, and he cannot kill everything. Like, if he locks in the Thunder Punch, he cannot kill the Lando, and... Yeah, even the Morwall, he doesn't die. Like, even Morwall doesn't die. So, Sabala can just click, like, Thunder Punch on whatever he has. Does he have Knockoff or Thunder Punch? He has a Knockoff, okay, and that kills. The Ditto loses its Choice Scarf. Thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned for Game 3, that's gonna go up maybe 1 or 2 hours after this, not sure the exact time. But yeah, Sabala wins this one, it's 1-1-1. 1-1-1. It's 1-1 now is what I meant to say, and Game 3 is gonna decide who is gonna stay in winner's bracket of ulti for round 5. And yeah, the other player is gonna still be in ulti and play in the loser's bracket, but it's way easier to win if you stay in winner's bracket, like the tournament overall. Sabala's actually doing really well. I think he's like 4-0 in Snake at the moment, or is it 3-0? Oh, I haven't uploaded one of his Snake games, so I shouldn't have spoiled that, but yeah, that game is gonna be coming next day as well. And yeah, just stay tuned for Game 3, more tournament coverage overall is gonna be coming, in general is what I meant to say. That was a weird outro. Peace out, friends.